real bad. Like it get crusty and big flakes and everything everywhere. And then now that I have short hair, it shows. Like it really, it shows. I could just scratch it and then we'll see a big old flake come out of nowhere. So this actually helps it tames it down. It keeps my moisture in my hair. And then I use the conditioner for it, the olive oil replenishing conditioner. And it just smells so good. It's the sweet orange oil that's inside of it. It's real good. So I shampooed my hair already. We're going to comb it out really quickly. This is a regular black comb. This one look dirty. We're just gonna comb. I'm not going to cut my hair anymore. I say that, but then end up cutting it. So, now I need to relax up here. I relaxed back, but I didn't relax the top. I relaxed the sides and the back. And then relaxed the top. So we are going to clip this. I'm gonna use that red tail. I want like a little curve to it.
Okay, so I parted my hair.
It's not the best part, but it would do. And then the dandruff. I know y'all can see the dandruff. That's what I'm talking about. I just washed my hair and that's the dandruff. That's cool because we're going to fix that in a minute. So, for the oil I use, sometimes I use like a leave-in conditioner. I'm not doing that today because I just don't. But the oil I use is the Jamaican Black Castor Oil by Mango and Lime. This is the Argan. And I really just put this like on my sides. If I put it on my top, it's going to leave it like oily. Or maybe I use too much. But it's going to leave it oily. So we're going to use the Black Castor Oil. Yeah, I do have a dress on. It's just a tube top dress. So I am wearing clothes. So I'm going to use this oil. We're going to open it. And then oil our sides and our back. I oiled my hair before I mowed it down. Just to like, when I get under the hair dryer, it will moisturize and activate, as I say. Just dab it in. And just massage it in. It's not molded. It's okay. I don't know if y'all can see a little piece right there. A little dandruff. Put a little oil on it. Okay. So that's out the way. Now the mousse that I use is the Lottie Body with coconut and shea oils. Wrap me foaming mousse. It smells good. This is what I use. This is. I'm just gonna. It's brand new. Just got it today. You want it as moldy as possible. Not moldy. You want it as foamy as possible. So put some in my hand. I do like so like these. But Tabitha Brown say like so like these because that's my business. Get the sides. Yeah, I know my hair grew like from a couple of weeks ago when I cut it. Cause it's all up on my ear and whatnot. But we still gonna keep it like so like this. Make sure we get this piece. So now we got everything phone down that we're gonna just, I normally either do like a finger wave or I just have it all straight down and then do, I don't know how I'm gonna do it or how I want to do it. Like a slight finger wave here, and then mold it down the bag. So loose. This goes here. And go. Yeah, remember, I'm not a professional. This is just what I like to do with my hair to get it the way that I get it to look. I am going to school for cosmetology in February. Going to Aveda Institute. Y'all, I got one earring in. I didn't even know it. Let me take this earring out. Let me take this earring out. See how the back looks. Looks very molded. Okay. And then the back, so not do my moldy, this little piece, this hair right here, I guess because the way my head is shaped, it gives it like this little bit, and so the hair comes up. So what I'm going to do is use this Eco Styling Gel. This is the olive oil and shea butter with black castor oil and flaxseed. I'm putting a little yellow on. I'm going to use a little bit and like help the molding to the back. Help mold this little back piece right here. I get the white ones. It don't really say which kind, but these are the black ones. I feel like have a better hold, better quality. Undo it. Some people tie their I can't think right now. Their wrap strip, and then some people like fold it across. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Put that here. And these are big. I think only might need like two. Well, to my fold it, they do like that. I'm not gonna do that because my fold head be and I need to secure it. Okay, so this is how it should look. Now this top piece, remember we're not gonna put any oil in it, but it should be already combed out. I am going to eventually put oil in it. Like later on throughout the week, I'm gonna put a little mousse and try to like set this. Come to the side. This is the side I'm gonna have my hair on. And go. Let's get on the hair dryer. I think I'll be on the hair dryer for like 25-30 minutes, and then I'll be right back. Show y'all how it look. Another I can see. Just literally. Now you can either keep this molded. I think that's what I might do. Just keep this down and mold it, and then just flat iron this part. So the flat iron. I'm using today is the Taishi Gold. I'm gonna turn it on. I turn it to like 14. Let that heat up. While that's heating up, I'm going to comb out the top. Y'all see them? Y'all can see them flakes coming down. And yeah, I forgot to use my heat protect. When you do your blow drying or your sitting up under the hair dryer, use your heat protect. So let me get my the heat protect that I'm using. What I use is the IC Vintasia heat protector straightening spray. This is what I use. I just want to spray it all over, comb it through. Yeah, we're just gonna flat iron the top. I'm not gonna really curl it today. So I'm gonna start at the front. Some people start like in the middle at the crown. I don't know how they get heat all the way through. Use my clamp. I'm gonna use my regular rat tail comb. Comb it. Remember, we're not using any oil today. If I wanted to like flow any oil in the hair today. Oh, do a little bump. Now I know I need a relaxer at the top. I'm gonna hold this flat iron a little at the top and create that bump. There we go. I'm gonna keep going. Alright. Apart. And as I get to the top, I'm gonna show y'all how I curl it so it'll look like something. Not look like something. It'll look like I curled the back with it. Like everybody should know how to flat iron their hair. Comb it out. Grab the flat iron. I can't see no more, so it's gone. I really don't need two passes, but I'm gonna do two passes. Now I want to flat iron my daughter hair. Well, do like a silk press, cause she is natural. Oh, that's too much hair. She is natural, and if anybody know like any good products to like use for her silk press, please comment down below. Make sure you guys subscribe. Like and comment. Give me some pointers. I'm not a professional. Let me know what I'm missing. I feel like it should be another piece of hair right there. see that it still shine without having any oil in it. Now that's that shampoo and conditioner. So that's what we have so far. Then, so like the sides, like here, I'm just gonna start flat ironing this way, like sideways, so it can flow with the hair, like flow with the cut. Yes, I cut my own hair. I feel like if we can watch YouTube all day for any other thing, we can watch YouTube on how to do our hair. But that's what I did. I watched a couple of videos, like Master Stylist, on like correct way to cut your hair, or self-cutting, DIY self-cutting. That was my thumbnail that I just did. And then we're gonna start, see a little piece of hair. I want it all to like flow together. I had a hairstylist in Dallas. Well, I have a hairstylist in Dallas that like, that's the only person else that can cut my hair, that I would allow to cut my hair. Her name was Terry. I remember my first time getting my hair done. She was like, "What you want?" I was like, "I don't know. This is my first time." So she did like a, I think she did like a bob. It was like a quick weave. It was a, like it was quick weave in the back. So it was just flowing. Then she had my hair going up into like a bun. I think that's when I fell in love with hair. Cause I was like, I don't know how she's gonna do my hair. And I would just learn how to do my hair. So all I had was that little one ponytail. And my mama was like, "Baby, you need to do something else with this ponytail." And I went to Terry. I think that's when I really started this little piece. That's when I got into like hair, like the way she used to cut my mom hair. And like she, my mom, I call it a mullet. She used to like, it would be like long in the back. And then like she had like this little mullet, but the way Terry cut it, it was like she cut it and then she styled it. And like the spikes was like going into a flower. It was so pretty. And my mom was always, "Can you," cause that's when I was starting doing hair. She's like, "Can you just curl it and spike it like Terry, baby? Anybody like Terry?" And, So I'm gonna see. Y'all see how it's like flowing with this? You can like, the back, you can brush it out. Comb it out, like not comb it out, but like just comb it. I'm not, because I like the way it came out. I'm gonna curl this like we're going towards the back. Sticking out. But yeah, I think the Tarian and my brother ex-girlfriend cuz, oh that's ghetto, my brother ex-girlfriend cuz, that was real ghetto. She like, she was doing hair and she used to like do his braids. Like he used to let me, my brother used to let me just play in his hair. Like, I'm gonna do zigzags like Mika. Well, I'm gonna do this and this and crisscross like Mika when I get older. So all I'm doing here with the flat iron is just like getting out my little kinks, my little waves. I know I need a relaxer. So I'm just taking, you can use a curling iron, but the flat iron is already on. And take your little while to comb. Y'all see that bounce? Look at that, baby. But no, we just go. Yeah, guess I cut my hair into layers. It came up. Yeah, that came up. But yeah, this is pretty much how I style my hair. You can add, I'm gonna add oil sheen. The oil sheen is not in here. But afterwards, you just oil sheen it and keep it done. Show your side. You can style it. I mean, you can even curl it back. I'm not curling back because I'm not going anywhere fancy. So if this is just the everyday look. Watch, do your little pink wave design and keep it cute. And I really feel like this shampoo and conditioner actually made it like silky looking. It's thick, but it's silky looking. And that's what I really, really wanted. Okay, so this is the finished look of my hair. I did go out and go do a little Christmas shopping. So it might look a little crazy. This is the look. He has body. Quick little pose. And there we go. All right, girls, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Plus,